जय गुरुदेव चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 1 फ्रॉम यूनिट 10, सक्सेस स्टोरी, एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज इफ। दिस चैप्टर इज अ सजेशन बाय द फादर टू हिज सन। ही पुट्स सम कंडीशंस बिफोर हिज सन एंड सेज दैट इफ ही फुलफिल्स दोज कंडीशन ही विल बिकम अ सक्सेसफुल मैन इन हिज लाइफ। सो हियर इज अ पोएम। If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. If you can wait and not be tired by waiting or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or being hated, don't give way to hating, and yet don't look too good, nor talk too wise, nor talk too wise. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two impostors just the same. If you can bear to hear the truth you have spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken, and stoop and build them up with worn out tools. If you can make one heap of all your winnings, and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss and lose and start again at your beginnings, and never breathe a word about your loss. If you can force your heart and nerve and sinew to serve your turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will which says to them, hold on. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings nor lose the common touch, if neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you but none too much, if you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it, and which is more, you will be a man, my son. Here are some difficult words. Let me tell you their meanings. First is blaming. Blaming is accusing. Next is allowance. Allowance means to compensate. Triumph, victory. Impostors, the one who pretends. Knaves, dishonest persons. Trap, snare. Worn out, used too much. Stoop, bent low. Twisted, distorted. Sinew, strength. Now here is the explanation. The poem If teaches us to stand unwavered in unfavorable and miserable circumstances. In this poem, the father trains his son that the day when he will become sturdy enough to brave the oddities of life, that day he will be called the man in true sense. Here father says that if you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. The father says that you have to keep your mind cool in both the situations, whether you win or lose. You should have firm faith in yourself, though people around you doubt your capability. Instead, you should polish your talent and make them numb by outshining them. The father suggests his son that no matter, you have to wait, but not let others wait for you. As you can see here, if you can wait and not be tired by waiting or being lied about, don't deal in lies, or being hated, don't give way to hating, and yet don't look too good, not to talk too wise. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same, if you can bear to hear the truth you have spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken and stoop and build them up with worn out tools. Now the father suggests his son that people might lie to you, but you remain truthful to them. They may hate you, but you shower love on them. It hardly matters if you don't seem good and wise to others. He says that dreaming is good, but not let your dreams overwhelm you. You should think, but be capable of translating your thoughts into actions. Don't make them aim of yours. Whether you face victory or defeat in your life, you should remain indifferent to them. You must tolerate the truth distorted by the crooked people to trap others, and keep watching the things getting shattered you have given life to. You should rather stand up, muster your strength, and get those things repaired with the things available to you. Next, if you can make one heap of your winnings and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss, and lose and start again at your beginnings and never breath a word about your loss, if you can force your heart and nerve and sinew to serve your turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will which says to them, hold on. If you have the piles of your achievements and someone overturn them, don't lose heart and don't curse them. Instead, you tone up yourself for the next turn to come. Remember, let go of everything except will. Keep holding it forever. Next, in the last stanza, the father says, if you travel among common people, you should outstand with your virtues. And when you walk with the kings, never remain unconcerned with the sufferings of common people. Always be neutral for your friends and foes, and for everyone. So, the father assures his son that if he imbibes his teachings and act upon his suggestions, then the whole world will be his, and he would belong to the whole world. And he will be called a man in a true manner. I hope you understand this point. Thank you. Jai Gurudev.